You pop in a game cartridge and turn on the system. You enter a dungeon and make your way through the various hallways and corridors. You know you have to find the exit, and you know you have to find 9 pieces of treasure before you do. But did I mention that you have no map? But don't worry. The best thing is... No, it's not an RPG with a lot of text. I wouldn't subject you to that. No, Daimeiro is a simple and straightforward crawling game that I personally think is one really fun time. Once again, you take part of an archaeologist lost in a world of portals and mazes, but this time you have to find 9 pieces of treasure before you leave. Simple? Not so much. You see, you're only allowed just so many steps before you start to lose life. You start with 10 hearts, and after every 10 steps, you lose a heart. But before we get into all of that, here's the controls. To move forward in a dungeon, press up. To turn around 180 degrees, push back. Left rotates yourself to the left, and right does the same. Turning doesn't cost you a heart, only moving forward. The B button brings up your inventory menu, while A uses an item from that screen. Select will give you a sky view of the map, but it costs 2 hearts to do this. And start will just bring up your map. Okay, I said that there were no maps, but just look at this thing. It's really not much of a map, but by collecting certain treasures, you can enhance this map quite a bit, but not enough so you're zooming through the levels. The items on the ground will help you out when you collect them. Many last in your inventory from world to world. So here's the challenge. You can collect hearts on the ground, but once you've gotten those, they disappear for the rest of the dungeon. Bombs will break walls with a bomb sign on them. Brooms return you to the start of the round or to a landmarker. The ring sets down a landmarker for you to come back to should you get lost. The compass adds a needle to your map to help you figure out which direction you're facing. Glasses enhance the top view surroundings by 1 block for each side. The pod increases your heart max by 5, but only for the current dungeon. Also, some of the walls will have icons on them. The heart icon plays a slot machine where the lucky cat, known as a Maneki Neko,
kitty,
plays either the slot machine, a game where a stone will fall down poles and you direct it by taking out different bridges, a trumping card game where you have to play a higher value card than your opponent, or a block rolling game. The block rolling game is my favorite, as you have to think ahead, as the block will only roll over colors that are like its sides. Now, you don't have to play these games, but it does give you the chance to get more hearts should you get lost inside of a dungeon.
Kitty!
And then there is the treasure. There are 9 pieces hidden within each dungeon, and you cannot escape without getting all of them. So you can see that it might seem like a simple game, but depth is what makes it so good. Now, and I'm really speaking from the heart here, I really cannot find too much that's wrong with this game. It's very straightforward, and it doesn't try to be something that it's not. The graphics are a bit meh, but it's a very tight game all in all. And there's so much gameplay. I mean, this game has so much stuff shoved into it, and it's really good stuff to boot. So, to wrap things up, this game is really one that should have been brought overseas. Everyone will really like it. There are several levels of difficulty, so it's safe to say that it's accessible to everyone. Not the greatest, but good enough for what it needed to portray. There's almost no Japanese, so everyone can play it once you understand how to play it. Simple and straightforward, very easy to learn. With 3 levels of difficulty, you will definitely want to play this game again and again. Though not the cheapest of carts, it's not the most expensive, but for the amount of gameplay you get for your buck, you really cannot lose. I only learned about this game in the past 5 months or so, and it's already quickly risen to one of my top 5 favorite Famicom games of all time. Honest, I really think that you should go out and find this game, and give it the old college go. And I think you'll be pleasantly surprised. So thanks for watching. And be sure to leave written or video comments about what you thought of this episode or about other games you might like to see me play in the future. Everybody's time around, so she can eat shot.